learning.
Wolf, in clinical detail, the criminal complaint lays out a sequence of moves caught on surveillance cameras less than 15 minutes that played out over a few city blocks, which federal prosecutors allege ended in the worst terror attack since 9/11.
According to the complaint, 2:38 p.m. on race day, about 11 minutes before the first explosion, two men are seen walking toward the finish line carrying, quote, large knapsacks. Tamerlan Tsarnaev, alleged Bomber 1, is walking in front. The alleged Bomber 2, Jahar Tsarnaev, now the defendant, is a few feet behind. At 2:41, the two suspects are seen standing about a half block away from a restaurant camera. A minute later, Bomber 1, Tamerlan, walks out of the crowd headed toward the finish line, a knapsack, quote, still on his back. At 2:45, alleged Bomber 2, Jahar, moves toward the finish line. He has the thumb of his right hand hooked under the strap of the knapsack and a cell phone in his left hand. The affidavit says he stops near a metal barrier, his back to the cameras facing the runners. He's apparently, their word, slipping his knapsack onto the ground. A photo from across the street shows it at his feet. He stands there for 4 minutes, looking at his cell phone, appearing to take a picture. Then the government alleges a deadly final 30 seconds. Just before the first explosion, Jahar Tsarnaev lifts the phone to his ear as if speaking on it. For 18 seconds, he keeps the phone to his ear. Then, just as he appears to finish his call, the crowd reacts to the first explosion. Quote, virtually every head turns toward the blast except Tsarnaev, who virtually alone among the individuals appears calm. According to the affidavit, he glances to the east and starts walking rapidly toward the west, away from the finish line, without his knapsack, which he left where he was standing. 10 seconds later, an explosion occurs in the place where he left the bag.
We also learned a little more today about the day the FBI released the video of the bombing suspects. The affidavit by Agent Daniel Jenk of the Joint Terrorism Task Force described a carjacking the suspects allegedly committed. It says one of them, not clear who, walked up to a car in Cambridge, Mass., pointed a loaded gun at the driver and said, "Did you hear about the Boston explosion?" "I did that."